How does the spirit of the cannabis protest movement today differ from its 60s counterpart?
Well, besides that people want it legalized because they enjoy it for one reason or another, there's the medical marijuana issue, which is especially good because only the... Well, how can I say this? It takes a great deal of faith, blind faith in the government, to believe that by taking medicine away from sick people, they're doing something to protect us from terrorism. That's their official line. And I have a feeling this is going to... Maybe I'm overly optimistic, I often am, but I think this is going to bounce back in their faces. They raided the Women's Alliance for Medical Marijuana, which is, distributes marijuana to about 300 cancer and AIDS patients, and a few with muscular dystrophy and post-polio syndrome and other problems, which are clearly helped by marijuana, very clearly and obviously. And they, the DEA swooped down, arrested the two people who owned the farm where most of it is grown, and chopped down all the plants and carted them away to destroy them, presumably. Everybody believed they were going to sell them on the black market. That's the most popular belief in the counterculture. They only seized them to sell them on the black market at higher prices. But the medical marijuana problem does make legalization of medical marijuana has a lot more support than across the board legalization. Even Dianne Feinstein, I think, is one of the most reactionary people in Congress. She's come out in favor of leaving the marijuana cooperative alone, medical marijuana cooperative. She's one of my senators. And my representative, Sam Farr, condemned the raid, and I forget his exact, he called it an outrage. And, I mean, we're getting more and more support on that issue. And as all the enemies of medical marijuana point out, as soon as that's legalized, there's going to be no control at all. Because how are they going to know who's got a medical problem? I mean, they're going to be harass a lot of people with that. It's going to be very hard to make convictions stick. It's only the federal government that's doing it anyway. It's very curious in where I live. 55% of the voters of California voted to make medical marijuana legal. And in Santa Cruz County, 85% in the countywide ballot voted to make it legal for any purpose. So people need it for medicine or they just want to get high. And it gets good for meditation and religious purposes. Or just because they all know it makes a blowjob even better. And I think all those are equally legitimate reasons. But medical marijuana is the test case. If they're taking medicine away from dying people in pain, they look, I mean, geez, that's worse than anything they've done internationally. And it's happening right here to American citizens. I think it's going to hit them, bounce back and hit them in the face. Maybe because I hope it will. As stupid as the American people seem to be a lot of times, I don't believe they're stupid enough to believe in taking medicine away from dying people. And most of the members of WAM are dying. Most of them are terminal cases. And they're in pain most of the time, and the marijuana takes the pain away, or at least eases it. In most cases, it takes it away for hours, or, you know. And the idea that these people with AIDS and cancer should die in pain because God doesn't want them to have any relief from the pain. I don't see how long they can hold on. It comes right out of the Middle Ages, you know. It's worse than medieval, the Dark Ages. I don't think they can hold on to that position very long, although they sure as hell are trying. I get my pot absolutely free from the Women's Alliance for Medical Marijuana, which doesn't charge. It's a cooperative. We all do what we can to keep it going. Now that they've been raided, we're going to have to do more. We're going to have to decentralize even further. We decentralize the production, the making of the tinctures, the cookies, the brownies, whatever form people want to take it and whatever is best for their condition. Some people still smoke it. We're going to have to decentralize the growth as well as the production and distribution. So what are they going to do? 85% of the people in Santa Cruz County are against the DEA. They gotta arrest the whole goddamn county. They gotta build a fence around the whole damn county and say we're all in jail now. I don't know, they might do that. I saw somebody who was kidding, but it sounds just like George Bush suggesting we build a bomb that will blow up the whole world. They cut out a hole in the middle of the shape of the United States, so we'll survive after we blow everything else up. Sounds like a great idea to me. There'll be no more enemies to fear, no more wars to fight. We can spend our money in the country. We might even get a health plan like the civilized world has. Everybody has health care. I mean, if we didn't spend all this money fighting with the rest of the world, we could have a health plan like England or Ireland or France or Germany or any Canada or Israel or any civilized country. We can't afford it because we're so busy fighting the whole fucking planet at once. They're not even finished in Afghanistan, and I doubt they ever will be, and they're getting ready to start a war with Iraq now. And Saudi Arabia or Iran is next on the list. I'm not quite sure which is going to be the third. It's going to be the Saudi Arabia or Iran. By then, all of the Muslims in the world, which are between 1 billion and 2 billion, depending on which estimate I believe, there's somewhere between, let's say, 1.5 billion. They're all going to hate the United States even more than they do now. Here we have a planet of 6 billion people who 1.5 billion hate the United States. It's so fucking crazy. I can't believe who's running this show, the Two Stooges?